What's up, divas? And what's up, divos? It's your girl, April. And you guys already know what time it is. It's Real Talk Wednesday. So we're about to get it on. We're going to dish out some stuff. I'm going to address some people in their ill-mannered ways. As well as that, I'm going to enjoy my drink. Now, I know this is in a Burger King cup, okay? But it's really not Burger King soda. I drank all the soda. The cup was still on the counter. I didn't feel like coming upstairs and getting my glass. So this is a drink like I always have, but I got a different brand this time. I think you pronounce that Pinnacle or whatever. Whatever, it's like that blue bottle. And it's really good. This is their Fruit Punch Vodka. And I just got some of that Donald Duck orange juice in it. I don't really get the Donald Duck orange juice too often. I'll just get like the store brand, you know what I'm saying? But yes, today I came on here with no makeup. I just got my eyebrows on and my wig on. And that's about it. So I do have like some really, really exciting news. Well, it's exciting to me. So I went to my primary care doctor, and she actually gave me a referral to go see a dermatologist. So I will be going to see a dermatologist on January 9th about my scar right here, because I do get a lot of people that ask me, what is that? Obviously, it's a scar. Duh. Don't write any dumb shit on my videos. Or how did you get that? Duh. What the fuck does it matter? It's a scar. But I have already explained this in several videos. It was actually a tiny, tiny, very, very tiny pimple. And it has just grown and grown and grown over the years. It does hurt. It does keep growing. It has kept growing. So a lot of people think it's a keloid, and it is considered to be a keloid. However, keloids do not grow. They are not supposed to grow. And so my body is like producing a massive amount of scar tissue. So I'm going to see how they can help me with removal of this. I have had a friend at my old job in New York, and she as well had one in the same area. She was a Caucasian girl, white girl. And a lot of white people don't get keloids. It's more or less like an ethnic thing, unfortunately. But she had one in the same area. And she had hers laser removed. However, it kind of like came back. So I'm not really sure what they're going to do. If they can cut it off or what have you, but we shall see. So I am like so excited about that, because like I said, it hurts. If it was just a scar and it wasn't hurting, then I really wouldn't bother me as much, but it does hurt sometimes. And the fact that it just keeps getting bigger, it bothers me as well. And plus, you never know what it could be. So I just want to get it checked out. Also, what else was I going to address? I'm going to physical therapy. So my primary care doctor has also sent me to physical therapy. So I go twice a week, Tuesdays and Thursdays. So of course you guys know that today is Tuesday. By the time this video goes up, it'll be Wednesday. I did go last week. Let me tell you, I think I really know how to walk. I already know how to walk. I don't need anyone to teach me how to walk again or walk the right way. I think I do a fine job at walking, especially because I don't fall flat on my face. But because my cartilage is gone in both legs and both knees, it's really hard for me sometimes to just deal with the pain. So they sent me to a physical therapist, and I'm also going to go see an orthopedic surgeon. So we shall see about that. You know what? Listen, I think all my parts are falling apart, okay? You know, it's like a brand, like a car. You got to replace that shit. I don't really want to get no new knees. I don't really want to get no new hip. I don't have to get a new hip. But you understand what I'm saying? If I want to get some new parts of my body, let me get some new titties so they could stand up real nice. Or like, you know what I'm saying? Just something else that I could just be like, yes, girl, yes. But either way, we're going to see how it goes. So I wanted to address this because it seems like there are a lot of judgmental people in the world. And everybody has their point in life when they judge other people. They talk shit about other people. However, here's the thing. I don't really think that a grown-ass person should go on anybody's social media, anybody's anything, and talk about children, about anybody's child, anything ill-mannered. I don't really think think that you should have the right to talk about anybody's child. And this is my thing. So I did post up a video. By the time this goes up, it'll be yesterday, of me and Mumsy, and we did a dollar makeup haul. It wasn't from the Dollar Tree. It was from Shop Miss A. And there's this person that had the audacity to write on my video, "Mumsy is so heavy, she's not doing herself any favors because she ain't cute either. She needs to lose weight or she's going to end up a lighter skin precious." And his name is, what is his name? Let's see. Sean Haynes. Now, first of all, here's the thing. Who the fuck are you? Anybody who's watching this, who the hell are you to be talking about anybody's kids? It's one thing to say some shit about me. A lot of people say you gotta have tough skin to be on the internet. And that's true, you do. Like, here's my thing. I don't really give a fuck if you say anything about me. You can say I'm overweight. You can say my freckles are ugly. You can say my teeth are jacked up. You can say whatever the fuck you want to say about me, because I'm a grown-ass woman. And if that's what you want to do and you want to put me down and it makes you feel better about yourself, then by all means, go ahead, because I really don't give a fuck. But here's the thing. Why would you write something about somebody's child like that? Like, my daughter is 9 years old. Who in the world said that being a certain size is politically correct? You know what? I'm so sick and tired of all of these skinny bitches and fat bitches always comparing themselves to one another, okay? And I don't mean that in a mean, nasty way, but we are one person. Who in their right mind said that you gotta be a certain size for it to be politically correct? Just because this bitch over here weighs 2 pounds and I weigh 15, don't make her weight any better than mine or mine's any worse than hers. Who's to say that? And for you to come on here and say, "And my daughter ain't cute either," who the fuck are you? Like, I'm just so surprised at how people could write shit about other people and it makes them feel good. I mean, like, I know, I get it. You ain't about shit. Your life ain't about shit. You probably don't have no friends, probably ain't got no job. You just, in general, don't got anything going for you. You're a worthless piece of shit. So you write about people's kids, and writing about someone's kids, of course, you know that that gets to that parent. So what is it? You want to hurt my feelings and you want to hurt me as a person, and so you feel like disrespected my daughter is going to make you feel a bigger, like, any better person. It's going to make you feel better about yourself. But a lot of people fail to realize you don't really know who the fuck I may know or somebody who's reading those comments may know. Now, I did tell you guys this before in a video back in May when I got rid of that asshole. My brother worked for the feds. And it wasn't nothing for him to get that nigga extradited out of Arizona State and get it to where he can't never come back here. The same thing goes with your comments. You write shit like that, you don't think because you wrote a comment that your IP address can't be traced because your comment. It could be traced. Trust and believe. You opened up a Google account, an account to leave a comment. It's so simple. You know what I'm saying? It's just so simple. Regardless if you did it by phone, if you did it by computer, if you did that shit by motherfucking air, you left a trail. So all I have to do, which I did, is give that screenshot and that video to my brother, give him the link, and allow him to investigate it. You understand what I'm saying, people? So when you do dumb shit on the internet, just be aware that it gets traced right back to you, regardless of what the fuck you say. And I'll be a bitch that'll come knocking on your motherfucking door like, "Oh, and what the fuck did you say about my daughter? Hello? Hello? You want to bring that shit outside?" Or better yet, I can just fuck with you for the long term, okay? And not even threaten you, but do malice shit to you that you wouldn't even be aware of and fuck up your life, the rest of your shitty ass life. So watch what you write about people's kids. Now, my daughter, she's the size she is, and that's her motherfucking size. I'm the size I am, and that's my motherfucking size. I don't understand why y'all bitches and whoever else is so worried about anybody losing weight or how anybody look or how anybody dress. And I'm addressing this to everybody because there were 4 thumbs up when the last time I looked on his comment. So I'm pretty sure that it was from 4 bitches, because I'm pretty sure a lot of men don't watch my videos, but there was 4 people that thumbs his comment up. So it's 4 fucking trifling ass bitches that be watching me but then thumbs that shit the fuck up. This the shit I'm talking about. Fake and phony bitches, I don't fucks with, okay? That's why a bitch like me don't have no friends right now. Because of fake and phony bitches. The same bitch that used to be my best friend talking shit about other people is now friends with them like they was best friends all their lives. Like, really? We don't do that shit. In Queens, New York, where I'm from, we don't do that shit. As being a woman in real life, we don't do that shit. You know what I'm saying? Be real about your shit. A lot of people come to my page, ooh, I love your realness. I love how blunt you are. Or I love that you ain't got no filter. No, bitch, it ain't about being no filter. It ain't about being no blunt. It's about who the fuck I am. I'm going to be real. And I'm going to tell you how it is. I'm not even how it is, but if you do something that I don't fucking like, I'm gonna say I don't fucking like it, okay? I'm not gonna sit back and not say nothing to you. What for? Because then you're gonna keep doing the shit and you're gonna keep irritating me. And my blood pressure is already high. So I really don't need your ass to be fucking irritating me any more than you have already irritated me. So let me put a stop to that shit right now. You know, it's a lot of controversy about plus size, thin size, thicker size. People always talking about Precious. I cannot remember her real name, but you guys know who I'm talking about from Empire. So fucking what? She's that size. She happy? Why the fuck does it matter to anybody how big she is, how little she is? Okay, what the fuck does it matter? You know, like I had to tell Mumsy yesterday, it had nothing to do about her weight. It had to do about what she put on. She had on some floral pants that was pink, just a bunch of flowers all over it. And her shirt was like tie-dye and whatever. And she was like, does this match? Because it was, both of the garments had the same colors in it, but it was just totally different prints. I said, girl, it match. If you think it match, and if you want it to match, and it's what you want to wear, then you wear that shit. Okay, that's just how I told her. Then you wear that shit. Because what does it matter if somebody else don't like it? Who the fuck said that this pattern gotta go with this motherfucking pattern? You know what I'm saying? Life be so short, and then everybody always worried about, oh, well, this person don't like this, or let me look like this a certain way to please somebody else. Let me tell you something. I have been pleasing people all my motherfucking life, and I'll be damned if I'm gonna please somebody the fuck else except for myself, okay? You know what I'm saying? So Sean Haynes, all of that shit you was talking about my daughter, don't be surprised if you get a piece of mail in the motherfucking mail. There's all types of things that you can do to people who write dumbass comments like that. Now, I could be on some real shit and get your address and your account info and your address and shit and have my lawyer contact you and I can sue you. Okay, people, you fail to realize the shit you write on social media, you can get sued the fuck for. And I'll be more than happy to take your motherfucking money, okay? I have no problems taking somebody's fucking money at all right? So watch yourself, because you don't know who the fuck I know, and you don't know who the fuck other people know that be reading the comments, okay? Watch yourself. And if you feel like my daughter ain't cute, I'm pretty sure that profile picture ain't yours, and I'm pretty sure your name ain't Sean Haynes. You probably some fucking dumb bitch that's been watching me since day one and be the first one to give me a thumbs down when the video's been live for like 10 seconds. It never stops, you know what I'm saying? I always get a few thumbs down and the video been up for 2 seconds. Really, bitch? What the fuck you don't like? The title? The fact that I uploaded a video? I mean, like, I know that these people that upload, that thumbs it down is people that subscribe to me. Because there's no way that a non-subscriber could get a video that just posted up. There's no way. Okay? So, you're subscribed to me. But you're subscribed to me because what? You hate me? Let me tell you something. I have unsubscribed and unfollowed bitches in general on social media and in life, okay? And they have unfollowed me as well and removed me from their motherfucking Facebook friends list. And I tell you what, I don't give a fuck and I could care less. My heart is not bleeding and I don't give a fuck, okay? It's about to be 2017, like I told y'all bitches last week, okay? If you ain't been fucking with me since 2016 or sometime in 2016 and I ain't fucked with you and I ain't called you in a minute, then trust and believe, bitch, you ain't on my 2017 fucks with list. I got very minimal friends that I fucks with, and I'ma just name a few. Miss Shayla, she my friend for life. Sometimes I may not answer the phone to her because I be busy or I be in the middle of something, but just know for a fact that I love that bitch because she's my friend. My girl Cowboy Chrissy, we've been friends since Mumsy was a newborn, and the bitch live in the next motherfucking state, okay? And we friends for life, okay? I will post some shit on Facebook, and she'd be like, "Oh, bitch, where's Mumsy? Oh, you just lucky Mumsy let you be in the picture." And she say shit like that, but I know it's out of the love, because this is how the fuck we get so along with each other. But that bitch, I love her for the rest of my life, because I know her, and that's a friend. You know what I'm saying? As well as, like, many other friends, my girlfriend Felicia, you know what I'm saying? I fucks with her. She's in Cali. I fucks with her, and she's gonna be a friend for life as well. And there's other bitches too that I fuck with. There's one that I need to meet up with, and she know who she is, because we gotta go to the Dollar Tree together, and she drive Uber, okay? I don't need to give y'all her name, because y'all ain't gonna get no motherfucking discounts, but she know who the fuck she is. And then my girl Donna, who does YouTube, but we've been friends before she's even done YouTube, okay? Since I started YouTube back in 2008 or 2009 on my other channel. So I fucks with them, and she lives out here in Arizona. So I only fuck with a few women, okay? And when I say women, I mean grown as women, and that's that. Other than that, I don't fucks with too many people. So like I said, if you want to throw shade, if you want to dislike, bitch, be real about the shit. Like I left a comment on the page, for y'all fucking dumb bitches that thumbs the video up, leave y'all motherfucking comments below and say what the fuck y'all gotta say. I really don't give a fuck about who likes me, who don't like me. But I really, really honestly feel like this. Like, a lot of y'all motherfuckers need to stop worrying about what other people be doing with their time and their life and with their body. Stop worrying about it. Because if I lose weight, is it going to make your life feel any better? Are you going to be any happier, any more happier than you are now if a bitch like me, lose weight? You know what I'm saying? Like, for real. Like, seriously. Like, are y'all going to feel any fucking better if I, April, lose weight? Is it gonna make your motherfucking life feel any better? If I go get my motherfucking teeth fixed, is it gonna make your life feel better? Like, this is the shit that I be talking about. Bitches be like, "Oh, well, get your teeth fixed," or say some shit like that. Bitch, get your life fixed, because what the fuck you worried about what I'm doing? Huh, your nigga like it, okay? Because he's steady DMing me. It's the shit. This is the shit that I'm talking about. Like, people, please stop worrying about what other people be fucking doing. Stop worrying about what this bitch got on her head. Stop worrying about what makeup or how her makeup fucking look. Stop worrying about how her outfit don't match or how you think it don't match to you. But who said your shit is fucking politically correct? Stop worrying about her weight. Stop fucking worrying about other people and get your shit together. If your shit was so together, people, you wouldn't worry about what other people's fucking doing and how other people is living their life. You know what I'm saying? Just like this Sean Haynes. If your shit was so fucking together, you wouldn't worry about anybody else's kids, okay? It wouldn't even bother you. You wouldn't be fucking worried about it. If your life was so happy, you would not be fucking worried about it. But here's the thing, Sean Haynes, you left your motherfucking comment, and I thank you very much, okay? Because your account information is liable to the public, all right? And don't be surprised if a lawyer come knocking on your motherfucking door, okay? Because Mumsy love money too. So now, we're going to get on to some real shit, since I already had to go and I addressed that shit for you guys. And I hope that you understand where I'm coming from, because it's 2017, it's about to be. And honestly, how I feel right now, sometimes I just want to be like, fuck YouTube, because I'm tired. I'm not even tired, but I be tired of the shit like this. But then it's like, you know what? I enjoy doing YouTube. I'm not about to let anybody irritate me like that. But then it's another part of me that's like, you know what? Sometimes you just got to go ham on a motherfucker, or you got to let them know how it really is. Like, so a lot of y'all bitches be getting on here thinking, oh, she's so sweet. She do videos with her daughter, and she do wig videos. She's so nice. Bitch, don't cross me. Okay, please don't motherfucking cross me, because I'm not the one. I am a really nice motherfucker. I'm really fucking nice. But if you cross me the wrong goddamn way, I promise you to pieces, it'll be the last time you ever fucking cross me. Okay, because you'll think twice about that shit. I'm not the one to fuck with. I tell people this all the time. You know what I'm saying? All the time. People say shit, or then they say shit in public, and I have to tell them, you really don't want to fuck with me, because I got five motherfuckers that will come right behind me and fuck your ass up. And those five motherfuckers is my kids. They don't play neither, okay? So when you come for me, you coming for all of them, okay? Every last one of them. Because them motherfuckers don't play. All right, these motherfuckers of mine do not play. So please, just be easy and watch what the fuck you write on my videos or in people's videos in general, because you open that account, whether you opened it with a fake name or not, it does not fucking matter. It reads your fucking IP address of where you opened the shit at. And it's just, people just really, that's why I don't be writing no dumb comments to people. That ain't even why I don't write dumb comments. It's just because, you know what? What for? I'm not an internet gangster. I don't do shit like that. If I don't like you, I'ma see your ass in person. I'm not even gonna go all out of my way for you because you're worthless. You're not worth my time. But if I see you, I see you. And then we can handle this. We can hash this the fuck out. Whatever the fuck it is you wanna do, we can fucking do that. But I'm not about to be on the computer like that bitch. Her daughter is not cute. And her teeth are fucked up. And I'ma throw some shade on her because I did not like her wig. Bitch, 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 bitch. Under a fake profile name. Or no profile. You know what I'm saying? No profile picture. Like, we don't do that. Like, I'm sorry, but we really don't do that. That's why I don't write no dumb comments on people's videos, because I don't have time for it. If I don't like what the fuck you showcasing me, then I'm not going to watch your video. I'm just going to click off of it. But I damn sure ain't going to be disrespectful to myself and to you and to write dumb shit. I just don't feel the need to. Life is too short. Why the fuck am I worried about what the fuck you doing? Yes. So on that note, if you guys got a real talk that you would like to be addressed, please go ahead and send me an email to muffinismylovers2012@gmail.com, and I will be more than happy to address the shit for you. Make sure you put in the subject line real talk, and on that, let's get on to the real talk. Now, don't be surprised if you come when the intro come back that I ain't got this wig on, because it's hot. And it's fucking itching my neck, and yes. Okay, so I told y'all I was going to, I had to take the wig off. That wig, I love that wig though. It's by, It's a Wig, right? Oh my God. Yes, it is. It's by It's a Wig. Arama. It's called Arama. Yes, it's already on my channel. I love that wig. It's so natural looking, but it was hot. You guys ever... Oh, it was hot. It was just itching my neck, and I think I was irritated, okay? I just was irritated in general, and I feel so much more comfortable right now. Honestly, I really didn't feel like doing anything today. So anyway, so listen, okay, when... Like I said, if you send me a real talk video or email, excuse me, and please put in the subject line real talk, please, please, let it be real talk. Don't write in the subject line real talk, and it ain't fucking real talk. This is the shit that I'm talking about. So, first email, real talk, because it says real talk, so I'm going to read it. Hello, April. I recently stumbled across your... You recently stumbled across you on YouTube and liked your real talk. I shaved my head and I have a lot of hair. I was wondering if you could use it to make a wig. And if you did make a wig, would you please send me a pic? First of all, okay, we're going to address that. So, this young lady named Pat wants to know if I could use her hair to make a wig with. And if I do, can I send her a picture of it? I mean, I guess that's considered real talk, but why the fuck would I want to take your hair and make a wig with it? There is a whole lot to making a wig, and using somebody's chopped off hair is not one of them. Like, I'm not one of those places that take donated hair for cancer patients. I don't know how to make a wig out of hair. However, I just thought it was weird. Like, okay, so you want me to answer your email? No, I cannot use your fucking hair to make a wig with, all right? No, I cannot. Nor would I fucking want to. I really don't want to get anybody's hair in the mail unless it's on a weave track, okay? And I'm not trying to sit up there, and all I'm picturing in my head, and I don't even know what type of hair she has, But this is what I'm picturing. Somebody with really coarse hair, and I'm just getting a big, big cotton ball. Like, this is, and I know that's wrong, but I'm just being real. You know what I'm saying? I'm being blunt. But this is all I'm picturing. Like, why would I fucking want somebody's hair sent to me? Like, I make a lot of, but she's not even asking me to make her a wig with her own hair. She's like, and if I did, would I send her a picture of it? Why the fuck would I want to take your hair, make me a wig with it? Like, let's be realistic. I get enough fucking hair. I don't need to take anybody's hair and make a wig with it. You know what I'm saying? Like, I love getting emails and shit like that, but please, people, the real talk is for real talk. Not dumb, not this shit, okay? I was about to say not dumb shit, but just not this shit, okay? Next, okay? Hey, Miss April, I'm not sure if this is considered real talk, but I could use some advice. Now, see, look how she started this off. You have helped me with some situations in the past, and I love you and your channel. The situation is a bit different from the others. If you don't think this is subject is fitting for a video, an email reply would be just as appreciated. I never look or feel beautiful. Now, this is a real talk. It doesn't have to be about relationships. I never look or feel beautiful. I have several issues I'd like to address and get your input on. I admire you for many reasons, and the way you present yourself is one of those things. I am a plus-size woman. I usually wear about a size 16. Me too, girl. That's the size my pants are. I am apple-shaped, meaning my extra weight is in my stomach. Hello, diva. Me too, okay? I want to lose weight, and I try, but it's an ongoing battle, and I'm not sure if I will ever win. Hello, honey. You are preaching to the choir. I'm about to send you my phone number. My hair is thinning really bad in some spots. Okay? Why do you think I use the topic? I am even developing some bald patches. I am white, just so you know my hair type, and I'm considering looking into the world of wigs. But I'm unsure of what should suit my needs or how to start. Some of the things I admire about your physical appearance. You always present yourself as classy and put together. I always look and feel like a slob. You rock your tattoos in a feminine and beautiful way. I have several tattoos, and I'm about to get a very visible one on my upper arm. I worry I won't look feminine enough to pull it off and look good. You know how to dress to flatter your body, which is banging, by the way. You just threw me off with that, but thank you so much. I tend to just wear comfy basics and not even attempt to dress cute due to my body shape. Okay, girlfriend, I got on a leggings, pair of leggings, and a big shirt. Your makeup and hair are always on point. Not today. Okay? I am good with makeup, but lately I can't find the motivation to do it. Hello? I touched on the hair subject above. The balding is really hard on my self-esteem. I know how that feels. I know this is a lot and it's really not specific, but I need to step my game up. I am tired of never feeling beautiful. My husband treats me like a goddess, but I need to do this for me. Any advice or tips you can give would be much appreciated. Sincerely, thank you so much. I'm going to call her Rhonda. So, wow. Rhonda, you're going to get an email from me. It's going to give you my phone number because I feel like we have so much in common. Okay, so you see what I'm saying? She admires me because this is how she feels that I present myself. Sometimes a lot of things can be a little deceiving on camera. All right, I just don't divulge all of my info to you guys or my feelings. And I do, but sometimes I don't. Let me tell you guys, when I take off my makeup, I look at myself in the mirror and I feel like I'm ugly. Like nobody's going to want me. Or sometimes I start feeling like, you know what, I'm just not presentable. I feel much prettier when I put on my makeup and I put on my hair. You know what I'm saying? This is how I feel about myself in general, okay? So I can understand and totally relate to how you feel, Rhonda, because I feel the same way. I am a size 16, and let me tell you something. Hold on, I'm going to show you. Better yet. Okay. So you do see that I have on some black leggings. Today, however, I said, let me put on my Olive Army Fatigue, you know, skinnies from New York and Company. I bought these back, it's 2016. I think I bought these back in like 2012, okay? 2011, 2012. They were, look, these are really, really cute. Okay, they wrinkle, but they're cute. I bought gray, beige, and green. And the size that is on the tab is, I hope you guys can see that, is a size 16 from New York and Company, okay? Now, I wore this size before me and my ex-husband started going to the gym together. It's before I lost all that weight. And I said I'm going to put these on today because they're probably going to be a little loose on me. Let me tell you something. When I first got these, they just fit. They fit good. They just fit. When I tried to put these on today, it was like fucking hell trying to put them on. So now, I'm like, damn, these are size 16 and they don't even fit to where they're comfortable like that. Like, I cannot have my jeans squeezing my stomach like that or my pants because it's so uncomfortable. And I said to myself, damn, I'm 217 pounds now. And I'm the same size as I was a few years ago before I lost all that weight. And I'm back to that size again, but it's formed in different areas this time, okay? So when I was bigger before, I was just more, I can't really explain it, but I was bigger before, but I looked bigger, okay? My face was fatter and everything. And my face is kind of chubby right now too. And I had to take those pants off because, I mean, I could have wore them, but I'm one, like, I have to be comfortable. I love to be cute, but if I'm not comfortable, then I just ain't with it, okay? I'm really not with it. And so when I walk outside and I look in the windows, I could see my size, my silhouette, and it's like, okay, April, all you need to do is lose your stomach because I like all of this. I'm happy with the hips and the butt. I'm good with that. But everything goes to my stomach area. And I'm not good with wearing those waist trainers all day. So I go to the gym and I work out. And it just seems like it's just not working out for me. Okay? And I'm not about to starve myself either. And then it's like, okay, April, you either going to have to wear a wig now or you're going to have to wear clip-ins now. Because my hair has thinned so much over the years. And I don't know if this is from wearing wigs since 2009, 2008, or just because I'm getting older. You know what I'm saying? So I can totally relate to Rhonda because my hair is thinning in certain areas. And you guys know that because you see me use the Topic hair building fibers in all of my wig videos. And that's to make my wigs blend and make my hair look a little thicker. But I know my hair is thinner because the fullness of the entire head used to be the fullness on one side of my head. And now it's like, damn, girl, you ain't got no fucking hair. And I mean, I have hair, but it's not as thick as it used to be. And that's depressing to me. You know what I'm saying? And who the hell wants to wear a wig or have to resort to wear a wig for the rest of their life? So I have come to the terms where I'm going to get my hair cut real short. Not really, really short, but short enough to where it makes me feel comfortable and it makes me feel pretty. And that's what the fuck I'm going to do because 2017 is around the corner. However, I totally relate to how she's feeling because there have been a lot of times when I don't feel pretty myself, okay? Some days I get up and I don't want to do my makeup. And then there are some days when I feel like I need to do my makeup because I want to be impressive and I want to feel pretty. But here's the thing, Rhonda. You have to first learn to love yourself. Now, I will tell you this much. Your husband, he treats you like a goddess, then that's a damn good thing. They are so hard to find when they are like that. Trust and believe. I'm going to tell you this really short story real quick. So I get a phone call on Saturday, Friday. And guess who it is? Because like I said, he be writing me and he writes the girls. He didn't know my phone number. So I sent it to him in a letter. Who do you guys think it is? It's my ex-husband, okay? So he's calling me and I've already read the letters that he's written to the girls about how, you know, your mom is the best thing ever, you're a doll, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. So I did send him some pictures with the letters. And he seen my size. And I will be honest and say, regardless of all the bullshit that I have talked shit about him, about he's drunk or he's drank too much or he's been in and out of jail too much because of his drinking or just because of his dumb shit, he was the only man that really, really loved me. And I can always tell this, and I know this for a fact, you know what I'm saying? My body appearance was not a major concern to him. He loved me regardless, and he was happy with who I am. So I tell you this, Rhonda, you have a blessing and keep him. And, you know, things happen for reasons. Maybe one day me and him could see eye to eye. And, you know, I sometimes, like, you know, there have been a lot of people that wrote in my divorce video, you shouldn't have got divorced. And you know what? Maybe I shouldn't have. You know what I'm saying? I regret it because I love him so much. I really, really do. And we all go through some shit in life. But, you know, absence makes the heart grow fonder. Absence also makes the person change for the better. So maybe this time that we have been apart has made him a stronger person, and it's made him get himself together, because he actually has gotten his bachelor's degree since I've left him, and he's done a lot of good things for himself. So I'm very proud of him for that. And sometimes you have to leave the person alone and make it harder for them, you know, tough love, so that they can get through things and not always count on you. But that's another story. But I just wanted to share that with you guys. So yes, we are conversing with one another again, and who knows where it'll go from there. But anyway, so Rhonda, you know, life is a battle in general. Battling weight is a fucking battle, you know what I'm saying? And I think a lot of the way that we feel, you and I, because I look at these beautiful girls on social media, and they look just gorgeous. They got their hair put together, they got their makeup put together, their outfits be put together, they just be looking snatched all around. And then here it is, I get up and I look in the mirror and I'm like, damn, April, you looking all frumpy. Look at you. But it's social media, and it's what, or it's television, it's what we see that's making us feel a certain type of way about ourselves. But have you ever stopped to think about these people that we are admiring? What do they think about themselves? Like you, Rhonda, you admire me because you feel like I get on here and I'm classy. I present myself. I wear clothes that are appealing to me, and so forth and so forth. Okay. Great, but you don't really understand the things that I go through and how hard I be kicking myself in the ass and how I have to have a drink every day because I be stressed the fuck out, or I feel ugly or fat, overweight. You know what I'm saying? This is how I may medicate myself, by having a drink or smoking weed. And yes, I carry myself classy unless I'm cussing you the fuck out, because I don't think that's too classy. But in the public's eye, out in the public, I'm not about to be trashy. But it's great that there are a lot of people that we may admire and may inspire us. But we have to keep in mind that these same people that we look at may be going through just the same thing or even worse than what you're going through. Because just like you said, you admire me because I'm the plus size too. And because my hair and I wear the wigs, honey, you would have never thought that the same way that you're feeling about yourself is the same way that I feel about myself. Not one day goes by, and I mean this from the bottom of my heart, not one day goes by that I don't look at myself and be like, damn, April, you fat. You need to lose weight. Damn, April, you need to lose weight. You need to lose weight. And I'm not trying to say, like, oh, I need to lose weight because of what society thinks that may be politically correct. But it's because I want to look like a certain thing or a certain size, okay? Or I just want to fit back in my clothes. You know what I'm saying? There are days when I feel like that and I'm really kicking myself down. And then there are the days that I have where it's like, you know what? I don't really give a shit about what society thinks of me. I don't really care if a man feels like I'm fat and overweight. Because if that's how you feel about me, then trust and believe, you're the type of person that I don't want to be around. You understand what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Like, people, like with this guy who said things about my daughter, Mumsy. Those are the type of people that I would never want to associate with myself, because you're a miserable person. And if you can so critique, judge a young child like that, then why would I want to be in any type of scenario involvement with a person like you? You know what I'm saying? You're the type of person that I stay the fuck away from, because if I don't, I'm probably going to catch a case. And I really don't want to go to bed. I don't want to go back to jail. You know what I'm saying? I've been there already for assault for 2 weeks. A bitch don't want to go back. All right, I really don't like it there. So those are the type of people that I steer clear from, because they're not worthy of my time. So those same people that you admire, you know, they go through a lot of things. And because you wrote that, everything that you wrote about yourself is the exact same thing about me. From the body size to the apple size to the thinning hair And even to the husband, even though he's my ex-husband, he still treats me the same way a goddess. Loves me to death. So I get it. It felt like reading this, it felt like I was talking to myself. Like I fucking wrote myself an email. You know what I'm saying? Like my daughter Tati says, people always body shaming. Body shaming. Body shaming. And it's sad because everybody thinks that you have to be this perfect A plus A1 bad bitch. No. What may be beautiful to some might be real fucking ugly to others. My body shape and body size may be amazing and beautiful to a whole lot of other people. And then there are those who just don't like it and may find it disgusting. You know what I'm saying? So it's to each his own. And like with your husband, he finds you a beautiful and he treats you like a goddess. However, Rhonda, get your oomph back and do shit for yourself. Nobody says you gotta live at the gym. Nobody says you gotta starve yourself. But do things to make you feel happy about who you are. You know what I'm saying? Do your makeup. You don't have to wear makeup every day. That's not who we are. I put on some eyebrows today and some eyeliner. That was it. You know what? I don't really care if nobody don't look at me like that. I am who I am. Sometimes I feel like when I put makeup on at the end of the night and I look at the makeup, it's like, ew. Girl, you put on too much makeup. You look like a cake face. Ew, take that shit off. Like, sometimes I feel like, you know what, April? Why would you want to wear all that makeup? It's just, that's just like doing the most. Like, God, just be who the fuck you are. You got the highlight. You can, you're covering up your freckles. Well, I'm not covering them up because you can see them still. But it's like they're dulled down and things like that. Like, you know what? I'm going to just be me. I'm not going to do all of that extra shit. And if nobody don't find me attractive, what the fuck do I care? Because then that means that you only digging me if I'm looking like one way. It means you're kind of like self-absorbed person. And those self-absorbed people, I just need to stay the fuck away from. But on some real shit, Rhonda, I can totally relate to how you feel because I be feeling the same way a lot of the times. And there are times when I'm just like, damn, bitch, don't eat that shit because you just gonna gain weight. And it's like, I want it. I want to eat that right now. This is what I want. This is what I fucking want. Like right now. I want a good ass burger. Okay? Not from Burger King because I do love Burger King. But I want to go to Five Guys. Burgers and fries. I want to go to Five Guys. And I want to get one of their burgers with all the fixings on it. Okay? With them good ass fries. And me and my mumsy, that's where we gonna go after this video is over. We gonna go right to Five Guys and we gonna get us a nice juicy ass burger, okay? And some french fries. And we gonna sit there and we gonna enjoy each other's company and we gonna enjoy that motherfucking burger and fries and we gonna have a good time, okay? Regardless of our weight. And I'm pretty sure that there'll be the motherfuckers that come with that look at us like, oh, them is some big bitches or whatever. Do it for you, Rhonda. Whatever you do, your husband finds you beautiful and he treats you like a goddess. Girl, make sure you keep that man, okay? Because, like I said, they are hard to find. But don't kick yourself down. And I'll be the first to say that. Don't kick yourself down. Because, I mean, I kick myself down a lot. There are nights when, you know, I look at myself and I'm like, damn, I look like my mom. I look like my mom. And my mom is 62 years old. And she let herself go a long time ago. And I'm going to just be real with you guys. She just let herself go. She's like, she didn't care. And when you don't care about how you look or you just don't care about yourself and shit, you can tell. I mean, like, it eats you alive. It really does. You start looking old and frumpy and shit like that. And I get it. Sometimes you want to be comfortable. You don't want to wear clothes that's so constricting. And when you're uncomfortable and your feet hurt and your stomach is hurting because the pants are too tight. I totally get that. Shit, a bitch don't like... Why do you think I took these pants off today? Okay, so like I was saying before, my memory card shut off. I get it. Why do you think I took these off? Like, I can't be restricted. I'm not about to be uncomfortable. But I will tell you this. You gotta sometimes do shit for you, for yourself. Don't allow society to get you down and put yourself down. Because we as people, we as women, we as men, we as people in general, we come in all different shapes, sizes, ethnicities. ethnicity. I can never say that word. But we come in, we're just different. We are all different. None of us are all the same. Though we may share a lot of characteristics, like you and I, we still are all different. And what makes the world go round is we're all different. Who would want everybody in society to be a size fucking six? Like, really? I put the finger up because it's bony. You know what I'm saying? Like, we're all different. We are who we are. Everything is there for a purpose and for a reason. We have bigger butts, or we have bigger stomachs, or we have this, or we're bigger in this way, or we're bigger in that way, or we wear size 16 for this reason, or we're rocking wigs. We all have a purpose, and this is us. We're all different. Nobody is perfect. I don't give a fuck if you look on Instagram and you see these beautiful ass girls. They are beautiful. You know what I'm saying? There are a bunch of beautiful girls out there that I've seen on Instagram with the little body shapes and pretty makeup. But let's just keep it real. At the end of the night, they may be so pretty and beautiful. How do you think their life may be? You don't know that they may have the best life. They may be alone and wish that they had someone. But because they're so beautiful, they go through bullshit. Or it could be a number of things. Or at the end of the night, what you see on Instagram can be a total different appearance at the end of the night. So I think a lot of things that play a part in society have to do with social media. You know what I mean? Because we look at other people and we compare ourselves to them. You know what I'm saying? We want to be like them. And then that's when we start kicking ourselves down. I have my good days, and then I have my days that aren't so great, but my good days are when I feel like this. Fuck that. I love my size, and I'm happy with the way I am, okay? And I'm not about to starve myself to death. I just want to be healthy. So what do? I go to the physical therapist, and I go to my doctor like I'm supposed to. I do what I'm supposed to. You know what I'm saying? I do what I'm supposed to. Even a lady at physical therapy, she was like, she looked like she wore a size 3, okay? Well, you know, because of your weight, that may be the reason for your arthritis. I just looked at her like, bitch, you better watch what the fuck you're saying. Because of your mouth, you might just lose your fucking teeth. Okay? Because you feel like I'm overweight. Who the fuck said that me being 217 pounds is overweight? Where's that written down in the Bible that April Furman can only weigh a certain amount of weight? Where does it say that? Okay? I'm perfectly fine. The only thing that I don't care for about myself is my belly area. Other than that, I like myself who I am. Yeah, I may have my bad days where I feel like I'm ugly because I don't have no makeup on and I don't have no wig on, but bitch, who said the fuck that I'm overweight anywhere? All y'all motherfuckers that be like, oh, that bitch is obese, so she's overweight. It's because you wear a size 6 and you feel so good about yourself, okay? But in reality, you really don't feel good about yourself. Let me tell you something, that old saying, don't nobody want a bone. Don't no man want a bone but a dog, okay? I'm sorry, but I don't want to be bony. And some people may say, oh, that's just what thick girls or fat girls say to make themselves feel better. No, bitches. I don't want to be boned, all right? I want some meat on me, and this is how I like myself. The only thing that I'm fucking worried about is my motherfucking stomach, and that's it. I don't even give a fuck about my thinning hair, because a bitch whoops over on a wig at the beginning of the morning, the end of the day, the middle of the day. I don't give a fuck about that, okay, or some clippings in. And as for makeup, yeah, a bitch is pretty with or without the shit. I really don't need it. Y'all got bitches that is put, they got fucking freckle stickers now where you can put it on. It looks like, some kind of thing, a mask, but you put it on your face and it's a sheet with freckles and you peel it off and it lasts for 3 days. I ain't got to do that shit, all right? A bitch got them naturally. I do get some people who be like, how did you do that? How the fuck I do what? How did you put those freckles on? I'm not even gonna go there with y'all. I'm not, but I have seen quite a few things. So, you know what, Rhonda? Just when you feel like you ain't doing the right thing or you not feeling pretty, trust and believe. Them pretty bitches on fucking social media is going through the most. And they is feeling just the same way. So whenever you do something, do it for you, because that's the number one key. And trust and believe, those who you admire go through the same shit, and I am one of them. Okay? I am one of them. So let Rhonda know how you feel. Have you guys ever felt in your life that you aren't perfect, pretty, you needed to lose some weight? I'm pretty sure that there are a lot of people that feel that way. I'm pretty sure that none of y'all bitches feel like y'all perfect. And if y'all do, then please unsubscribe, okay? Okay, Diva, so on to the next. Hi, you can call me Candy for this video and my ex, Bobby B. Is that supposed to be like Bobby Valentino? So I've been on my own since I was 13, and I met Bobby B when I was 14. He was 15. We had our ups and downs, and he was even there when I was pregnant. I found out that I was 12 weeks after a month of being with him. I knew the father was locked up, so I told Bobby V, and he was happy and hurt all at once. He stepped up and was there, but his mom had a problem with it. So that led us to break up, but he was still there. I was a high risk and end up having a stillborn. Oh, wow. Even though we were not together, he was still there. His mom sent him to live with his older sister out of state after everything happened. We still remained in contact. I turned 18 and got into a bad relationship with a guy. We can call him Tim. And when I was 19, my brother got murdered, and that's all it took for Bobby B to come back when I needed him the most. So I left my ex, Tim, and Bobby B and me got real serious. So we almost got married, but called it off because we were so young and were fighting so much over little things. So I moved out and in with my mom. That made us go different ways for a while. But love brought us back together, and one really drunk night, I cheated on Bobby, and he found out through my twin brother, and I denied it. Then the dude I cheated with calls Bobby and tells him, now there's a problem. So I tell him how it happened, and he's like, we're going to work through this. Weeks later, he says it's over. I cried and cried, and now he's moved to Tennessee. Do I still try and fight to be with him? Because I know he's all I want and ever will want, and he's the only one that can deal with me and my 1,000 different personalities. Or do I really give up and be 21 and single and have fun? Please help me. I love how real you are. We was together for 5 years out of the 7 years we have known each other. Am I crazy? So, Candy, you have been on your own since 13? Well, goddamn. I try to figure out why do people say, well, I've been on my own since I was 13, or I've been on my own since 14. What if you've been paying bills and you've been paying rent? I don't really think you've been on your own. Your parent might not have really cared for you like that, or, you know what I'm saying? But you ain't really been on your own, because I don't foresee no 13-year-old being on their own since they were 13. Like, why do people say that shit? My daughter's 14. If I was to put her out, do you really think she's going to be on her own and pay her rent? No, she's not. Okay. So here's the thing. You and Bobby V. Why has it got to be Bobby V? Okay. Shit, I call him Bobby Brown if I want to. But we're going to just call him Bobby. I'm not going to add the extra fucking alphabet to the end of it. No, we're not going to do that. So basically, Bobby and her have been together since she was 13. He was 14 or 15, whatever. She got pregnant, had a stillborn. It wasn't his baby. They broke apart. He was sent to live with his older sister. Unfortunately, her brother was murdered. And that really sucks. I don't even know what to say about that. And she just was going through rough times. And Bobby V was there for her. She was in a relationship with someone at 19. And anyway, so Candy got drunk one night and cheated on Bobby V. A lot of people like to use liquor as an excuse of the things that they do, okay? Here goes my fucking liquor, and I didn't drink it all. I'm never going to use this as an excuse. I have been drunk numerous times, many, many, many motherfucking times, okay? Never have I come on here, or never have I had to, the, I never had to say, oh, I was too drunk, so I didn't know that I fucked you, okay? I've never had to say that. I've never had that reason to say that, thank God. A lot of people feel like when they get drunk, they don't know what the fuck they're doing. Yeah, there are times you don't know what the fuck you're doing. But I'm pretty sure you know that you're kissing on somebody that ain't your motherfucking man, okay? And I'm pretty sure you know when you open the motherfucking legs that you know. You motherfucking know, okay? Because if you're so drunk, dick is the last thing you want. I'm pretty sure that porcelain god, meaning the toilet, is what you really want. Because a bitch like me, if I get too drunk, I just want to see the toilet. Because I'm going to have my face up in that bitch until the wee hours of the morning, okay? There have been many times when I have been really drunk, and me and my ex-husband, he has tried to get it on with me, but I think that he stopped on account of he didn't want to wear what was inside of my stomach on himself, okay? So, yeah, blame it on a liquor, like Jamie Foxx says. Just blame it on a booze, blame it on the alcohol. Blame it on a liquor, okay, if that's what you want to do. Now, here's the thing. You 21, you want to be 21 and single. Listen, Candy, you have been through a lot in motherfucking life. I think it's time that you slow the fuck down and get to know Candy, okay? Instead of hopping around and back and forth. Yeah, you love this motherfucker. That's cool. Y'all have had young love. 13 and 14 years old really should not have a boyfriend, okay? That's just my thing. And you just said you was 13 and pregnant. I'm sorry, but you should have not even been pregnant at 13. At 13 years old, a bitch like me was still playing with dolls. I'm just saying, okay, because that's what the fuck it was. But there's too many of these young girls today that just want to open up their legs and feel like playing home makeup and mommy the motherfucking dearest is a cool thing to do. Pick up a doll, or how about you pick up a book and read the real world and how that shit really is. And then you bitches will be really quick to be like, I don't want to have no kids, okay? Trust and believe, I'll be the first to tell y'all motherfuckers that. Now, he done moved away. He done went back to Tennessee because you done cheated on him. He's 21, 22, 23, you 21. How about this? How about you leave him the fuck alone and get to know Candy? Because obviously you don't know Candy too well. You done hopped from one relationship to another, moved back in with your mother. You and your ex-boyfriend, Bobby Valentino, have been arguing over the littlest things. Don't you think it's time to take a motherfucking break? Get your education. Get a good job. Move out onto your own motherfucking apartment at 21 and have some motherfucking fun. At 21 years old, I had a kid already, okay? I think I had two, right? I don't remember. But, yeah, I think I had two. I'm not really sure. Maybe not. Probably not. But either way, I had one of the motherfuckers. And let me tell you something. If I could rewrite history to this day, I would tell you guys this. I might do things a little bit different, but I don't regret the kids that I have because I love them to death. And even though the first one that I had, I was 17 when I was pregnant and I had him when I turned 18, I don't regret it because he has taught me a lot in life. And being a mother at a young age has taught me a lot in life. However, there are those who just don't get it and really need to find themselves. And Candy, you being one of them, stop worrying about a boyfriend and a man and grow the fuck up. You live at home with your mama. Okay, what you gonna do, chase him across the motherfucking world? If he is in his own world right now because you have cheated because you were so drunk off the liquor, off the alcohol, then let him the fuck be, okay? Leave him the fuck alone. It has nothing to do with, oh, if he loves you, he'll come back. No, how about this, bitch? If you love yourself, maybe you'll come back. Maybe you'll snap back to reality. Because obviously, you've been on your own since you've been 13, you've gotten pregnant, and you've been through a lot of tragic shit in your lifetime. That shit adds up in a lifetime. It makes you grow older, it makes you look older, it just makes you numb to reality, and then sometimes you do so much dumb shit in life that you don't know what is real and what is not real, or what is wrong and what is right. That's what's wrong with a lot of people. They do so much shit as a young adult, like partying and drinking and drugging and shit, that when it's time to grow the fuck up, they can't. They don't know what the fuck to do with themselves. They're either their brain is fried or they're caught in this world where they think that this is how reality is supposed to really be. Living with your mom and shit at over the age of 21 and boyfriend hopping and finding this one and that one is how it's supposed to be. No, everyone loves love. Everyone needs a relationship. That's what they fail to realize. That no one has to be in a relationship all the time. It is a beautiful thing to be in a relationship. It is a beautiful thing to have a man or a woman love you, okay? That is the truth. However, you have to love yourself and know your worth before you can go chasing after anyone. Now, if you knew your worth so much, you wouldn't have fucking slept with somebody regardless of the alcohol. And if you were in the fucking drunken stage, why the fuck were you with another man getting drunk when you had Bobby Valentino at home? I'm just saying. Okay, think about it. So you was drunk. You weren't with your boyfriend when you were getting drunk. You was with the next dude. So, bitch, you was cheating all along. Or you was cheating off the rip. Or you was hanging out with some motherfucker. Either way, you was getting drunk and you weren't getting drunk with the person that you were supposed to be with. That's what I'm trying to get you to realize. If you were so in tune with Bobby V, you would have been drinking with him instead of drinking with the next dude. Okay, who is irrelevant, who really don't give a fuck about you. So no, you don't go chasing after him because that's not what we do, okay? Because you were the one in the wrong and he's tired of it. And not only is he not tired of it with your 1,000 personalities, like you said, but if you can sit up here and tell me you have 1,000 personalities, then there's nothing wrong with you. You're just stupid, young and dumb and full of cum, and you need to get yourself together and have a reality snap back, okay? Because you're 21, you live at home, you've had a lot going on in your life. How about you take a trade or some type of skill, learn how to live on your own and take care of business and then try to find a man? I'm pretty sure at that point in your life and you gotten things together, the right one will come along. That's what bitches fail to realize. When you get your shit the fuck together, you will attract the right motherfuckers, okay? Yeah, you probably got some pond scums coming along too in the midst, but you know how to deal with them. You know what I'm saying? Just like that thirsty motherfucker that I told y'all about who texted me talking about he hungry. He want to eat some pussy. Yeah. Okay? Them niggas come in all shapes and sizes and I'll be the last one. A bitch might not have her shit together 100%. Talking about myself. But I got my shelf together 95%. And I can still see the pond scum coming towards me. I see that shit real quick. Yes. So, on that note, I'm pretty sure I talked you guys' ears off from the beginning to the end with my rant, with my advice, with everything life in general. And I do want to wish you guys a very Merry Christmas because Christmas is this Sunday and I hope you guys enjoy with your families. I'm still sitting here trying to figure the fuck out what I'm going to make for a Christmas dinner. If you guys have any suggestions, please write them below because tomorrow's going to be Thursday. I need to go to the grocery store. I was going to make some oxtails. I mean, I still am because I really do love oxtails. But not everybody in my house loves oxtails. But they're really, really good the way I make them. So, and I was going to have Tati make some baked macaroni and cheese. I don't want no more turkey. I can't take no more dry-ass turkey. Maybe I should make, like, some roast chickens. What do you guys think? Like, give me some ideas, some suggestions. I don't really want to sit there and cut the freaking cabbage up. I don't want to do all of that, but I want some dinner. So let me know what you guys' suggestion is for a Christmas dinner, and enjoy your holiday. And as always, stay diva and divalicious. I love you guys, and I'll see you in the soon to come video.